thing to keep rice and beans in your house. But when you come to University of Nigeria on Soka campus, you see this thing? As far as you're going to stay in the hostel, you must buy. You are going to wee-wee inside this thing and you pull inside this thing. I go and throw it away. So anybody that is in hostel that is over big girl, just know that this is where it all ends.
Like this is the corner D over there, this is the corner D, and this is the corner B. Let me show you a view from here. It's actually how it looks. Then this is how the hostel actually looks like. This is the corner D over there, this is the corner D, and this is the corner B. Let me show you a view from here. It's actually how it looks. Then to cook, you just put your stove here and your cake. That's how it is.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, the Ada Sugar, Ada Ezequiel, Ada Diorama, Ada Peperempe. Yes, that's me, your asset. Yes, all these names are for me, of course. So if this is your first time on this channel, you are welcome. Welcome to the family. And I'm sure that by the time you are, in fact, you must not even be done watching this video. You can just subscribe. Please click on that subscribe button, that red box. I think it's here. Yes, I think it should be here or here. I don't know. Please click on the subscribe button. Now I'm sure you're going to love this video, so please give me a thumbs up and, you know, share, of course. So guys, and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you once again for clicking on that link, for clicking on that thumbnail. You are welcome, and you guys are the OGs, okay? So guys, from the topic, I'm sure you already know what we're going to talk about. I'm going to talk about what it's really like to be in UNN hostel, or what it's really like to be in a federal school, a federal university hostel. So in case you don't know, I have a UNN playlist. So my UNN playlist on my channel, just open my channel, check my playlist, you'll see that I have a UNN playlist. My UNN playlist consists of everything and anything you need to know about UNN, both about pharmacy, because I'm a pharmacy student, about pharmacy, UNN, things you need to know about UNN, everything about UNN is in that playlist. So you can go and run my playlist, you know, just run your girl's playlist if you're interested in UNN videos. And I also have other videos, so please do check out my channel. So now without much rambling, let's get straight. Welcome back guys. First of all, before I start talking about UNN hostel, I want you to know that I'm filming this video from my UNN hostel. Yes, I'm filming this video from my hostel. As you can see, when you stay in a hostel, you might not get the best background. You can actually buy a backdrop, you know, something you want, but you might not always get the best background because you don't really have all the space in the world. That is it. And all the videos I've been making this year, I've been making them from my hostel. If you guys, this is the first time I'm actually changing my setting. Most time I always film from, you know, I film behind the curtain or in front of the curtain. But this time I decided to change the view so that you guys can see what, at least just a little glimpse of what the hostel actually looks like. So if you're a content creator, you want to, you know, also be using your, you want to be creating content or doing things, don't be so scared. You can still make use of your hostel space. So now I'm going to be talking about some topics that, you know, for you to be watching this hostel, you might fall into the category of you just got admission and your father told you, you must stay in school hostel. Like that's what my dad said. He told me you must stay in hostel at least for your first year. So if you're in that category, you don't really have a choice, or you don't really want to stay in the hostel, but you just want to know, okay, let me see, let me even know what this hostel is like. Because I remember when I got admission, I was craving for information so bad. I checked Google, check YouTube, check everything. I couldn't find any information whatsoever online about UNN. So when I now got admission, I'm like, okay, why not? Let me make this easier for people, at least the things I couldn't enjoy. Let me make it easier for you guys. So the first thing I think about hostel is that your school hostel depends on your school. If you are in a federal school, then you might have the standard hostel. That is like this type of hostel I mean, where you are four in a room. Like in this school hostel in UNN, the standard is 4 in a room. We have the corner A, B, C, D. Corner D is for first year, corner C, second year, corner B is for third year, then corner A is for final year. That is how the hostel is. And in this hostel, the typical hostel setting is that in the hostel, we have the corner A and C, then corner B and D. Corner D doesn't have a wardrobe. You just have half of the table. Then you have your bookshelf and you have something like, you know, that wood thing that can just be hanging your clothes. Yeah, that is what you get in corner D. That's for the first year corner. Then for corner C, you get a wardrobe, just a small wardrobe. Well, the wardrobe is sizable. You get a wardrobe, you get your shelf, and then you also share table with the first year. Then for the corner A and B, those are third year and the final year corners, you get a full wall, you get a full wardrobe, you get a full table. Your corner is obviously bigger, so you have more space. But obviously, as a final year student, you are supposed to get more space. That is it. But if your school is a federal school and has a private hostel, then private hostels are usually hostels built by private organizations. They just lease it out to the school for a period of time, or maybe now becomes a school, depending on the contract signed. So private hostels are really nice, but currently UNN doesn't have a private hostel. Either you stay in the general school hostel or you just stay off campus. Then if you are in a private school, your hostel will be totally different, because I remember when one time my friend in Babcock was trying to get hostel and she was legit screenshotting, "Oh, this hostel I want is filled up." She now screenshotted and put it on our WhatsApp status for we to help her and decide which hostel she'll stay in. I was just so surprised that UNN portal, that to get hostel in UNN is war. So immediately they just open one room for you, click it with the speed of light. Click that hostel with the speed of light and go and pay. Like, rush to the bank and go and pay. I was so surprised that she had the convenience to even be picking the one she wanted, to be putting it on WhatsApp for us to choose. Baby girl, that doesn't happen in federal school. We have over 10,000 people fighting for that same space you are fighting for. So nobody even has time to be doing all those things. That's it too. So now, I'm going to talk about the toilet. I'm sure some of you might be wondering that, "Oh, I don't stay in a hostel because I don't have my personal toilet. How will it be? I cannot share this and that." I don't know about other federal schools, but in UNN, I'm going to be specifying about UNN because that's the school I'm in. So in UNN hostel, like in this hostel, we have 6 bedrooms and 6 toilets per wing. In a wing, we have 12 rooms in a wing. So the 12 rooms share the 6 bedroom and the 6 toilets. How it works is that for the bedroom, we have 6 bedrooms. So it's just like in boarding school, where you want to bath, you have to wait for your turn. Though at times we don't really have queue like that, but if there's a queue, you just have to wait for someone to be done using the bedroom. And we don't close the bedroom door, like, not even personally, generally, just some people that close the door when they're bathing. But it's not like anybody will come and be staring at you. I don't know, like, if I'm waiting for someone, obviously I can see you having your bath, but it's not like I'll just come and be staring at you. Just prepare your mind for that in case you're coming to the hostel. Then about the toilets, it is a public toilet and you're a lady, you can't just be sitting anywhere. So in the hostel we have pee bucket. Let me show you an example of the pee bucket. In fact, let me go and bring my own pee bucket for you. We have a pee bucket, aka potty. So how it works is that you ease yourself in the pee bucket, then you throw it in the toilet. You pull in your pee bucket, then you throw it, just like how a potty works. You cannot sit down on the toilet seat, not because you're not allowed to, but because it's not good for your health. The kind of infection you catch, baby girl, if you sit down on that toilet seat, the kind of infection you're going to have, all these gogo rubo and happy clogs and all those antibiotics people used to swallow, it will not help you. So it's better for you to just use that pee bucket gently and gradually. Let me show you guys an example of the pee bucket. This is what the pee bucket looks like. Oh my god. So as you can see, this is a pee bucket. I'm sure some of you use this thing to keep rice and beans in your house. But when it comes to University of Nigeria on Soka campus, you see this thing? As far as you're going to stay in the hostel, you must buy it. You're going to wee-wee inside this thing and you pull inside this thing. I go and throw it away. So anybody that is in hostel that is over big girl, just know that this is where it all ends. That is it though. That's life we're living. But we're still big. If you see me on the road, don't insult me. Na condition make a fish bench. And hostel is not bad. So, another thing in our hostel is our light and water. Funny enough, as I was filming this video, they actually took the light. But I'm going to cut it down. They actually took the light and everybody shouted, hey, but now they have turned on the gen. Thank God. Let me film sharp sharp and go and sleep. Because this is like 8 o'clock. This is 8 p.m. Now, I went to school today, so this is free time I have to film this video. Another thing is serenity. The problem a lot of people have in hostel is serenity. What if I come back from a stressful day and I just want to come to my bed and sleep? And then my roommate's friend comes to visit her. I can't chase them away. Because, I mean, she also paid for her space. So I can't chase them away. The best I can do is to tell them to please reduce their voice. That's one problem people have in hostel. Because you're not really sure of how it is. Except your roommates are the type that don't really accommodate friends and all those type of things. Or maybe you want to sleep or something. And then, maybe I'm cooking. Or my roommates want to sleep. Then I start cooking and I start frying pepper. And everybody is coughing. The best thing I can tell you is sorry. Because I'm not going to stop cooking my food because of you. Like, that's just it. And everybody cooks, so things like that can disturb you. You want to read, somebody is gisting with their friend, or the one that annoys me, people that used to play music every day. Not even playing the music with your phone, or you carry Bluetooth speaker. And be like, there was one time someone in one of my rooms, someone came to visit my roommate. Visit though, Gina was like this counting the days for this girl to finish her visit and leave. Any in the morning, she'll carry Bluetooth and be playing song. Okay. Afternoon, she'll be playing. Like, she was always playing song. As far as she's in that room, she'll play song. When I told her, why are you always playing song? She said that she liked music. And then everybody, that time was not exam period, so everybody was just cool with it. But I was like, so if we're having exam, this is how you be playing music and be disturbing everybody. Every time, Bluetooth speaker, every time. So that's one of the things you can face when you're in the hostel. Another thing is where the studying, but you and your roommate will end up coming to a conclusion and know how you will do things, because you know they should also be reasonable and equal guys should be able to talk and know how you do things. Another problem is roommate wahala. I'm sure some of you have watched movies of with Dominic and Genevieve, when Chema Chukwuka will go to university, she will not meet Genevieve and with Dominic. They will not spoil her. They'll be smoking, be doing runs, be going to Abuja to collect chip. You will not be like, hey God. I remember when I was in SS3, I was like, God, because I'm going to university, give me good roommates. Don't give me roommates that will spoil my life. Don't give me roommates that will scatter my destiny. Don't give me roommates that will force me to go and do what I don't want to do. Like, seriously, it was a concern. But you know, they say good and bad communication corrupt good manners. But you know, that's also where your value and training has to come in. I know that everybody can easily get influenced by peer pressure, but that's where your training, all the training that I've been training you all your life, that's where like it comes into test. Because this is the real world. And even when you start working, different things, you can't just be chasing people you don't like the attitude away from the surface of this earth. You have to learn to deal with it. That is human resource, human management. So that's one of the things. So if you're scared that you have roommates that maybe runs girls, or they are heavy, or they're into drugs or something like that, and you're just scared that, God, please, I don't want that type of roommates, pray, because before you now go and start, or they'll go and use their own to cobalize you, they'll go and put you into trouble. But it's not always like that. The hostel environment is kind of secured. Like, once you stay in the hostel, you are sure at least nobody smokes inside the hostel. Like, nobody. Even if you smoke in the hostel, you surely get reported and you get kicked out. So at least you can be rest assured that nobody smokes in the hostel. You can drink. Yes, drinking is not allowed. The alcoholic drinks are not allowed in the hostel. But you know, you can't really control that. So people drink in the hostel, but not like drinking to stupor. But at least you are sure that you'll be breathing fresh air. No, nothing. That's why a lot of girls who smoke, they can't stay in the hostel, because you can't just wake up and be smoking inside your room or even in the corridor or anything. So at least you'll be sure that that one is out of the way. And some things are controlled, because you know, you're not the only one in the room. So guys, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comment section. Or if you know you want to have a one-on-one chat with me, feel free to send me a DM at my Instagram page at Ada Ezekwelu. Thank you for watching. And if you know you're not subscribed, please click on that subscribe button. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And please share it to your friends. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video. Bye.